And in the Stockholm talks, some experts say North Korea and the U.S. might have been unable to move ahead because they had two very different timelines. Oh Soo-young reports.
North Korea and the United States are working on different timelines to hammer out a deal on denuclearization. That may be the essential problem that led to the breakdown of the recent working-level talks in Stockholm.
But we're very focused on sanctions relief and on some kind of security guarantee. But I think there's a third kind of maverick piece, and that may be playing into these working level negotiations as far as these summits and what would be required to hold the summit. And that gets to the second point, which is timing. You know, when I look at these statements, especially the North Korean statement is very focused on the timing. And actually, if you parse their phrases, they were frustrated that they didn't hear enough from the Americans, and the Americans stressed the importance of having lots of meetings.
While North Korea has set the year-end as the deadline for the U.S. to break the deadlock in the stalled negotiations, President Trump has said repeatedly that he's not in any rush. Most analysts say Trump's own timeline is likely set for November 2020, in time to give him a boost for the next U.S. presidential election. But to clinch a deal that's worth supporting, experts say Trump needs to get involved and fast. Dr. Mark Barry says no negotiations between the two sides have succeeded on a working level without intervention from the top leadership, citing how it took former President Jimmy Carter to convince Kim Il-sung to freeze the North's nuclear program in exchange for light water reactors and heavy fuel oil in 1994.
My perception is that the North Koreans have a lower view of this State Department's negotiating capabilities than did the North Korean diplomats under President Clinton or the North Korean diplomats under George W. Bush. I think personally that the United States needs to treat the Korean issues more as the United States had treated the Arab-Israeli issues, as an honest broker, having Camp David summits as was done in 1979, the Camp David two summits between the Israelis and the Palestinians that President Clinton invested 2 weeks of his time in. That's how it has to be done.
It's unclear whether the U.S. can convince the North to return to Sweden for talks in 2 weeks' time. But experts say any further discussions may require a personal touch from President Trump. Oh Soo-young, Arirang News.